वेलकम टू रसशास्त्र क्लास। नमस्ते बिटिया, खुश रहो। मैं चल जब डॉक्टर देवाशीष थानीग्राही। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक ऑन कपर्द। कपर्द कॉमनली इज नॉन एज कोरी और कोड़ी इन हिंदी। In English, it is known as marine shell or cowrie, having various Sanskrit synonyms like barataka, barata, barati, baratika, kapardaka, kaparda, kapardi, balakridanaka, चर चराचर एटसेट्रा। काउरी इज ए सी एनिमल इन द स्नेल कैटेगरी विथ साइनी एंड हैविंग वेरियस कलर्स कलरफुल सेल्स। It lives in shallow water of warm seas. Cowry may be from 5 to 6 inches long with triangular base. It is hollow inside. The top of the shell looks like a colorful egg and the underside has a long narrow opening bordered by many small teeth. There are around more than 150 kinds of cowries. Some kinds are extremely rare also. Cowries were once used as money in ancient times. The chemically it is CaCO3, calcium carbonate, and geologically it is Cypera moneta family, Cyperidaceae. Currently it is very commonly used, commonly available in the Indian Oceans, Maldives Islands, Sri Lanka, Malabar Coast, etc. In any sea beaches, it could be easily found also with slight variations. According to Ayurvedic Rasashastra texts, it has following subtypes. Basically, it is categorized in three types according to Rasaratna Samuchya, that is Shrestha according to size, it is described as 1.5 Nishka or Sardha Nishka Bhara, around 6 gram, also synonym said Charachara, and the Madhyama or the medium quality is 1 Nishka, around 4 grams. And Kanishta variety is Padana Nishka, that is around 3 grams by weight. According to its color, variety is of three types, that is Bruhat Rasaraja Sundara reference, that is Sweta or white color, is Tikshna and Chakshishya Guna properties. Swana or the reddish color is Hema, Sitabirya, and Vrana Nasaka, wound healing properties, having spots and lines, and Balagraha Nasaka also. The Pita variety, the yellowish color, is Gulma and Pustiprada. According to Rasatarangani, it is Bharatika Tridha Prapta, Pita, Sweta, Cha, Dhusara, युतत्तमा मध्यमतु श्वेत अन्य अध्यमा मता means according to Rasatarangani it is of three types the whitish one the brownish one dhusara and yellow one and the yellow one is best variety and others are inferior quality while describing the characteristics and grahya agrahya qualities Rasaratna Samuchaya has very vividly describes Pitava Granthika Pruste Dirghavruta Bharatika Rasa Vaidya Vinirdishta Sa Charachara Sangita Jo Bharatika Yellowish color ka hota hai Pushtabhag Granthi Nodes hote hain, nodules hote hain aur Dirgha Lambe hote hain वो बराटिका कहलाया जाता है और रसोवैद्य उसको चराचर संज्ञा देते हैं और इसका जो भार है वजन है वोट है वो अराउंड स अर्ध डेढ़ निष्क अराउंड 6 ग्राम के बराबर होता है निष्क भराचो मध्यमा जो वार निष्क का होता है वो मीडियम क्वालिटी का होता है पादन निष्क भराचो कनिष्ठ परिकृति का यानी कि जो अराउंड 3 ग्राम का होता है वो कनिष्ठ वाला होता है द कौरी सेल्स व्हिच इज येलोइश इन कलर हैविंग ए बल्ज इन द बैक एंड लॉन्ग सर्कल इज नोन एज चराचर बाय रसद्रव्य इज द बेस्ट वैरायटी regarding the Shodhana procedures, it have various references, but here we are quoting only Rasatarangani. Rasatarangani quotes Nimbukamla Drabhyopeta Dalayantre Bharatika Parishvinyatu Yameikam Suddhi Mayatya Uttama. So the liquid media advised is Nimbukamla, the acidic media of lemon juice. And the instrument used is Dalayantra and the process done is Swedana process. It should be done for 1 yama or around 3 hours. By this way the Bharatika or Kauri we get the Sodhita form. In Marana also there are various references. Here we are describing only Ayurveda Prakash reference. Angaragnu sthita dhamata samyag profullita yada swanga sita bhuta tamtu vishwa samyag prayajita. So, Suddha Bharatika should be heated or subjected to temperature of our Angara coal. The heat should be given up to its becomes puffy and after triturations and self cooling Bharata Bhasma could be obtained. Some other references also can be found. Purified cowries are sealed in the saucers properly with rag and malt and dried in the sunlight. Then it is subjected to heating with the help of goat's feces as a fuel. On cooling, it is in self cooling, the cowrie are taken out of saucers and sarab and grounded into fine powder. A moon white insulation is formed. The mode of heat mentioned in this procedure is karisagni, that is, the heat is obtained by burning bright faces of the seabird. It indicates that the amount of heat required is for a short duration and of low intensity. With intense heat, calcium carbonate will get transformed into calcium oxide, which is very hot and irritant. It seems that ancient scholars were aware of these changes on experimental background. Hence, only limited heating is suggested just to reduce the hardness of the cowries. Before preparing this incineration, In practice, the cowries are heated well and the powder. The powder is processed with alloy vera juice, konya soraso. It eliminates the untoward effects of the cowries. Some tests are also advised whether it is cosmized prepared properly or not. Before using incinerated cowries for medicinal purposes, it should be tested as follows. The taste of basma should not irritate the tongue and create any burning sensation on the tongues. If so, then incinerated cowries are again processed in alloy juice. Otherwise, the basma is kept in water for some time and the sediment at the bottom is collected and dried and then used for basma. The basma can be filled in gelatin capsules and then used to avoid its contact with top. As we already described, the quality of basma should be sarada indu niva, means the moonlight, the appearance of moon in sarada ritu, that is bright white color. Properties and dose, according to Rasa Tarangani, it is Dipani, Usna, Nayana, Atanka Harini, and Karna Srava Hara, Vannim, Agni Mandya Hara, Panti Sula, Disamana, Grahani, Gaja Singhika, Shayas Kota Paha, Rusya, and dose is recommended as 2 Ratti. However, here we can again describe. Kapardika Bhasma is hot in potency and pungent in taste. It elevates pitta and vata dosa. It is also astringent, hence it is very effective in chronic colitis. It stimulates appetite and improves digestion and thus elevates flatulence also, indigestion, vomiting, abdominal dolphin, etc. Externally, it is used with great benefit in chronic suppurative colitis. The basma is instilled into ears along with lemon juice. It cleans the ear and also reduces the foul discharge from the ears. But generally, it is used in hyperacidity and peptic also. Some important formulations of Kapardika is Lokanatha Rasa, Ratnagarbha Pattali, Prabhala Panchamruta Rasa, Padrantaka Loha, Grahani Kapata Rasa. As it is a calcium component, so apart from its medicinal effect, it is also used for its nutritional value in calcium deficiency, and it is very much useful for general debility and in women's disorders, gynec problem, etc. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, then mention in comment box. I will reserve it. Thank you.